Here I'm asked to solve a quadratic inequality. The first step is to determine the critical values. The critical values for a quadratic inequality are the zeros. So what you have to do is take your x squared plus 3 and set it equal to 0. In this case, I have x squared equals negative 3, extracting the root. Don't forget the plus or minus when you do that. I'm left with x equals plus or minus I times root 3. Notice that's imaginary. When you get imaginary critical values like that, that just means there's no real critical values. Okay, so there's no critical values for this. The second step is to make a sign chart. Now, a sign chart is pretty easy when you don't have any critical values. Basically, you have one big interval, so you could test any value you want. And it's always easiest to test zero. So when you test 0, you'll have 0 squared plus 3, and certainly that's greater than 0. So no matter what number you plug in, x squared plus 3 will always yield a positive result. Question here, well, the next step is to answer the question. So we're going to use the sign chart to answer the question now. The question is, when is this quadratic greater than 0? In other words, when is it positive? So I'm looking at my sign chart and it's positive always. No matter what x value I choose, I'll plug that in and I will get positive results. Think about it. Anything squared will be positive plus 3 will always be greater than 0. Okay, so here's my sign chart with my answers shaded in. Let's convert that to interval notation. Interval notation, that's just all real numbers from minus infinity to infinity. In the back of the book, you might see that expressed as a fancy R for all real numbers.